Should you go to film school? You're gonna get a lot of different answers from people depending on who you ask, but for me personally, no, you shouldn't go to film school. And here's why. Film school or going to college in general is really expensive. And at the time that I'm recording this, Google is telling me that the student debt in the US is at $1.5 trillion. Film school tuitions, depending on the degree that you get, can cost you almost $100,000. And that is a lot of money. And it's money that can easily be invested elsewhere. So if I go onto the LA Film School website and look at the degree that most applies to me, the tuition for that degree is $91,370. Not to mention that if you take out a loan and you have to pay interest rates, it's gonna be way more than that. Now, if I had that money and I had to start my video career over again from the beginning, here's how I would spend it. To start off, I would buy a really cheap camera that's within your budget. Don't worry about getting the best camera and don't worry about the specs. It matters more that you have something to practice with. It can be an entry-level DSLR or a point-and-shoot camera. And for the sake of the example, let's just say that the camera costs $500. Buying an expensive camera when you're a beginner is a really bad idea because you're not gonna know if you're going to fully invest yourself into this yet. You think you do, but realistically, you have to do the work for a long period of time to really know if you will or not. So if you end up losing interest in film and photography, then it's something that won't really burn a hole in your pocket. Next, I would binge watch as many YouTube channels about video and editing as I can. A majority of these videos are going to teach you techniques that you're not going to learn in film school because film school typically teaches you how to do things by the book, which isn't a bad thing, but most of the things aren't possible or even practical for a new filmmaker. As a new filmmaker, you're going to be doing everything low budget, DIY, and guerrilla style. And that is the best way to learn things because you learn how to work with tons of limitation. Versus learning while having all of the equipment at your disposal, it may teach you how to use it, but it doesn't teach you how to work without it. Next, I would make a video about everything I can possibly think of. Film trees, film skateboarding, film a girl in slow motion, it doesn't matter. Just film something, edit it together, and do it 100 more times. Don't focus on it being good. It just matters that you do it 100 times and learn from every single video that you're making. Somewhere in between those 100 videos, I would start offering free video services to people. It could be family members, a wedding, musicians, local businesses, it doesn't matter. The point is to get myself used to filming videos for people and learning the business side of filmmaking. And while I'm out filming, I'm gonna be driving a lot and buying food, so let's add a few $100 to this budget. Next, I would find a production company to intern for. That way I can learn from people who are already getting paid to do the work that I want to be doing. I can learn from professionals and see how they run a set at the cost of gas money. I've talked about this before in a different video, which you could find here. Next, I would work as a production assistant on as many different sets as I can. And it doesn't matter what you do. You could be the guy that brings the director coffee. You can be the guy that carries stuff in from the vans. You could be the guy driving the vans. One of the things I would highly recommend though, is shooting behind the scenes footage for those productions. Behind the scenes is gonna be one of the lower prioritized things in a production's budget. So if you were to offer that to somebody for free, it doesn't really cost them anything. And if they don't like the footage, then there really is no loss to them. And if they do like the footage, then it's a really good way to get your foot into the door and a really good way to start building relationships with the people that are running these sets. Interning for a company is good, but it really helps when you work and learn from multiple people because everyone has their own way of doing things. It doesn't matter what you're doing. Just be someone who offers an extra hand on a production. Being in that environment and shadowing the people around you is gonna teach you a lot about how a film set works. Pick their brain and offer to be a free assistant to them so that you can learn as much as possible. Going with them on their jobs and them showing you the work that goes into what they do will teach you a lot more than film school will. Pay close attention to how a set works. Pay attention to how the directors set up their shots. Pay attention to the moments where things get rushed and hectic. Absorb everything that is going on around you because all of these experiences are going to show you how a real production works in the real world. And that's really it. I would keep doing these things until you create a consistent flow of work for yourself. And from those experiences, you're going to learn filmmaking a lot faster than a film school can teach you. And it costs way less. yes, and you can actually get paid while you learn versus paying a six-figure tuition fee for a field that doesn't care about your degree. People would rather hire a talented high school dropout over a film school grad with no demo reel. And as you grow as a filmmaker, start investing more into your craft. Buy better equipment, buy courses, invest into personal projects. All of these things are gonna cost a lot of money, but it's not gonna come anywhere near as close as a film school tuition. All of the gear, courses, and personal projects that I've invested in, it hasn't come anywhere near as close as a film school tuition. If you came out of a film school with that level of debt, it's gonna be way harder for you to get started. It's gonna be difficult to take risks in a career field that requires being risky, and you're not gonna make that much money for the first couple years most likely. And for most people that just graduated college, they gotta work and get paid as soon as possible to pay off that debt. So to conclude everything, in my opinion, don't go to film school. All of that money that you are gonna be spending on the tuition could be better invested into just doing it on your own, and you're gonna spend dramatically less money, and you're gonna be making money in the process, and you're gonna learn a lot more in a shorter span of time than you will doing the year and a half or 2 years or so, however long it takes finishing a film school program.